गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। Is my voice is audible? Are you able to hear my voice and screen? Mark your attendance using three parameters. Okay. So till now, this is the video lecture on design and analysis of algorithms. Okay, so we have discussed with module one, that is module one, introduction to algorithms. Okay, so now we are going to discuss module two. So till now we have gone with various algorithms and all. So recurrence relations and some examples also we have discussed. So now we discuss with the module two. So here it is a type of a design and analysis of algorithm type. Okay, so types of algorithm we have seen. So which are the types of algorithms? It is divide and conquer, greedy, dynamic programming, backtracking. So totally we have four types. Okay, so divide and conquer, greedy method, dynamic programming, backtracking. Four types of algorithms. So now we shall see all the four types are the four remaining four modules. Okay, so remember this one. So these are the four types. We have four modules. So can anybody give which are how many types of algorithms are there? How many types of algorithms? So kindly type in the chat box, then only you can easily understand the entire module two. Okay, so how many types of algorithms are there? We have already discussed in the module one. Answer in the chat box. How many types of algorithms are there? How many types? There are four types. Okay, so that four types are the four modules what you are going to have it now. Okay, so four types are four modules. So one is the divide and conquer method. The other one is greedy, third one dynamic programming, and last one backtracking. Okay, so now in that divide and conquer, what is the concept you are going to have? So there is a problem, divide that problem to get the solution in smaller time. So understand carefully. So if there is a problem, divide the problem into sub problems, okay, to make the problem easier and to generate the outputs. So generate the output fast. So divide the problem into sub problems, find the solution, and then conquer all the sub problems into problem. So if there is a problem P, divide the problem into sub problems P1, P2, P3, find the solution for sub problem P1, P2, P3, and conquer. Conquer means you collect. So once you divide, collect all the solutions. So that we are going under divide and conquer method. Okay. So divide and conquer method, we'll be seeing like that. So divide the problem into sub problem, and then you find the solution for all the sub problems, and then you organize all the sub problems output into one. So that is the divide and conquer method. So are you understanding right? I hope you are understanding. So I will tell you again. So what are all the topics you will be discussing in this module 2? So general method, recurrence relation. So if these two methods are known, you can easily solve all the applications. So where this divide and conquer method will be applied. So it will be given under binary search, how to do, finding maximum and minimum, merge sort, quick sort, stress and multiplication, advantages and disadvantages. After divide and conquer, the other one is decrease and conquer approach. So decrease and conquer approach, and finally topological sort. Totally all this will be the topics what you are going to study in this particular module 2. So come for the first topic. So what is the first topic here? It is general method. So under general method, I've already told you. So general method, you will have a problem is there. So that problem of size n. So first you have to divide. Okay. Divide the problem into of. So a problem of size n, we are going to divide it into two. That is subproblem of size n by 2, subproblem of size n by 2. Okay, so once you divide, now you find the solution to subproblem 1, and again solution to subproblem 2. Once you find the solution for both the subproblems, now you conquer and make the solution to original problem. So this is the concept what you are going to have. In divide and conquer method, take the problem of size n and divide it into subproblem. Subproblem of size of, subproblem of size of. So parallelly, you find out the subproblem for both. So find the subproblem, solution to subproblem 1, solution to subproblem 2. Okay. So once you find the solution, so that will give you the solution to original problem. So are you people getting? Are you people getting? Are you people getting right? So that is the divide and conquer. Okay, so this is the divide and conquer concept what we are going to discuss. So this is the abstract programming code for divide and conquer. Abstract programming code for divide and conquer. So what is DA and C? Divide and conquer. Divide and conquer for the problem P. So keep this one in your mind. This is the algorithm for entire divide and conquer method. So algorithm divide and conquer for a problem P. Okay. So when, if the problem is small, you can't divide. If the problem is so small, then you can't divide. So that's why we have taken, if small of P, small means if the problem is small, then return S of P. S of P is nothing but small of P. Else means if the problem is not small. So if problem is not small, what you have to do? Divide the problem P into sub problems. So sub problems, we call it as smaller instance. So divide the problem P into P1, P2, PK, such that PK should be greater than or equal to 1. Okay. K, what is the K you are taken? It should be greater than or equal to 1. So that is the constant, that is the first statement what you are taking. If it is, the problem is small, then just return. If the problem is big, so divide the problem into smaller instance. That is P1, P2, PK. Okay. So once you divide, what is the next thing? So this is the steps what you have taken. This is P1, this is P2. So now you find solution to P1 and P2. So that's why we are telling it as divide DA and C to each of the subproblems. So apply divide and conquer to each of the subproblem to find what? To find the solution to the subproblem P1, P2, and so on. Understanding? So divide the problem P into P1, P2, PK. Apply divide and conquer to each of the subproblem. So once you find the solution to all the subproblems, what is the next thing? Combine. So here you are going to combine both the solutions to find the solution to original problem. So that's why we have given written combine DA and C P1, DA and C P2, DA and C PK. So first you divide the problem, apply DA and C to each of the subproblem, and combine D and C, P1, P2 up to PK. This is the abstract algorithm for divide and conquer. So keep this one in your mind. So this is the, what is this? This is the abstract programming code. Or if they ask you, pseudo code. So abstract programming code or pseudo code for divide and conquer, you have to write this algorithm. Okay. So this is the pseudo code for all the algorithms for entire divide and conquer strategy. Okay. So that is up to general method. So can, how many steps? So can you tell the steps of D and C? What are the steps of D and C? So reply in the chat box. So what are the steps of D and C? So you should tell this particular thing, then only I can move forward with the next concept. What are the steps you have for divide and conquer? Chat in the chat box, please. Type in the chat box and send to me steps of D and C. How many steps we have? There are three steps. Okay. So which is the step number one? Which is the step number one? Tell me. Step number one is divide the problem into sub problems n by 2. Okay. Step two. Step two. Okay. So totally I given all the three steps. So step two is solution to sub problems, and step number three, solution to original problem. Okay. So now you come for the next. From here, you will be having the problematic parts. Okay. So that is the general method what we have seen. Now you come for the recurrence equation. So we have gone with a recurrence equation for factorial tower of an I like that, right? So here also you'll be having recurrence relation for each and every concept and each and every algorithm. Okay. So under the recurrence relation, now you have to keep this recurrence relation. Okay. If the size of the problem P, the size of the problem P is N, and sizes of k sub problems are n1, n2, nk. Keep in your mind, the entire size of the problem is n. So once you divide the problem into sub problems, so how many sub problems? It is k sub problems. One problem is p and its size is n. Okay. So problem p size is n. So k sub problems, how many size? So k sub problems, the size is n1, n2, nk. Okay. So then you have to give the recurrence relation. So T of n. So T of n is the recurrence relation word, that is the name we have given, is equal to G of n if n is small. Okay. If n is small, we can't divide that one. That is that we consider it as small. If the problem is cannot be divided, so that one we are going to take it as small. So for that case, if n is small, so what is the recurrence relation? It is G of n. Okay. If the n is small, it is G of n. If n is large, so what you do? It is T of n1 plus T of n2, T of nk plus F of n. So this is the recurrence equation for divide and conquer. Okay. So you have to go with two cases. Is of size n, and if it is divided into sub problems, how many sub problems? K sub problems. Then K sub problems will have size n1 into nk. So okay. So if the problem is small, what is the recurrence relation? It is G of n. Okay. If problem is big, so if problem is big, what you do? You divide that into sub problems. So each sub problem is containing size n1 into nk. So that's why we give it as T of n1 plus T of n2 plus T of nk plus F of n. So I will tell you what is the F of n in the coming examples. So now you come for T of n. T of n is the time for divide and conquer of the problem of size n. Okay. So T of n is the time taken for the divide and conquer for the input of size n. What is G of n? It is a time to compute answer directly for smaller inputs. So if the problem is small, if you can't divide the problem into sub problem, then we take it as it is a time to compute answer directly for small inputs. So G of n is for what? If n is small, no need to divide. That time you will get G of n. If n is big and you need to divide, so then you get this one. Okay. So G of n is the time to compute answer directly for small inputs. So now T of n1, T of n2 is for time taken for the input of size subproblem 1, subproblem 2, subproblem k. Then come finally come for F of n. F of n is the time for dividing the problem and combining the solution to divide. Total time will be F of n. So starting with dividing and up to combining. So entire thing we call it as F of n. Okay. So T of n is time only, time for the divide and conquer for the input size n. G of n, direct answers. F of n, time for dividing the problem and combining. The entire thing we call it as F of n. Okay. So what is the recurrence relation we have? So what is the size of the problem P? Can you tell me what is the size of the problem P? Size of the problem P is N. How many subproblems are there? How many subproblems are there? Okay, subproblems. So each subproblem is having size. Each subproblem is having size n1, n2, nk. Okay, good. Okay. So now come for this particular. What is T of n here? So it is up to step one. Take it as step one, step two, step three, step four. So T of n is for how many steps, can you tell? T of n, so take the step one, step two, step three, step four. Totally four steps are there. T of n is for how many steps? Whether it will start with step one to step four, or step one to step three, or step one to step two. T of n. What is T of n? So just you go through here. T of n is the time for divide. Divide and conquer method on any input of size n. So it will have from how many steps? Step one and two. T of n, kindly you should tell me, then only I can go with the problems. T of n is the time for divide and conquer of any input of size n. So it will go with how many steps? Where is the input size n? So it will go with step one and step two. So divide and conquer method for dividing the problem of size n. So size n will come from where to where? So divide the problem into n by 2 and n by 2. That is step one and step two will be T of n. Okay. So G of n you can't get. What is F of n? F of n in this case, how many steps? So how many steps you have F of n? So F of n is the time for dividing the problem P and combining the solution to subproblems. So keep this one. It will go with dividing the problem. It will start with step one and combining the solution to sub-problems. So where you combine here, combining the solution for the step sub-problems. So it will go with step one, dividing the problem and combining the solution. So dividing the problem at step one, combining the solution at step four. So f of n you will be having from step one to step four. Okay. So now you come for the equation. Equation for divide and conquer. Okay. So you take that a instance. That means a problem of size n can be divided into b instances. That you should take it as a problem of size n is divided into p instances. P means subproblem. So of size n by b. Okay. So the problem of size n is divided into p subproblems of size n by b. So assuming n is equal to b power k. So if now you have to go with small problem, and now you have to go with big problem. Okay. So you have to go with small as well as big. If small, so what is the thing you will have? You can't divide. When you can divide, you when it is minimum of two, you can go with a divide. So if n is equal to one, you can't divide anything. So at that time, keep in your mind, when you can divide, when it can be divided a minimum of two. Two irbeko. You can divide it by two. Okay. So if n is equal to two, you can easily divide into one, one. But if it is one, you can't divide. That's why we take it as small. So go with if n is small means what is the case? N equals one. So at that time, g of n. So g of n, we take it as t of one. Okay. So now you substitute t of n1 plus t of n2 plus t of nk. So that we take it as a t of n1, n2, nk. So that we take it as n by b. A t n by b plus f of n. So how many instances you are dividing the problem? The problem of size n, that is p1. Problem p1 is divided into B, subproblems B. So that's why we take it as A is the constant T N by B plus F of N. So this is the case when N is greater than 1. Okay. So when N is equal to B power K, so you take it, this is the recurrence equation for divide and conquer method. So where F of N is the function that accounts for time spent on dividing the problem into smaller ones and combining the solutions. Okay. So have you understood? So this is the formula you have to keep in your mind for all the concepts. So recurrence equation, for that you will be substituting and finding the order of the growth. That is the only concept you have. For each and every problem, you will be substituting this particular formula and finding the order of the growth. So order of the growth will give you time complexity. Understanding? So kindly reply here. Have you understood or want me to tell again? So keep this particular formula. So a problem P of size n is divided into B subproblems. So here we have seen problem P of size n. Okay. So case of problems we have taken it as case of problems we have taken it as b sub problems of size how much n by b. So at that time, so now you assume n is equal to b power k. So if n is small, it will be t of n. If n is more, you have to substitute a is the constant, t of size. What is the size? The size we have taken n1 into nk, n1 into nk. But here you have taken it as b power k. So what is the size? It is n by b. N by b is the size. In place of k, you are having here b. In place of instance, you are having the problem p, we call it as instance. Okay, so it is at n by b plus f of n. At n by b means it is the dividing the problem into sub problems. That how much is the size of the sub problem? It is n by b. Okay, where f of n is function that accounts for time spent on dividing the problem into smaller and combining their solution. You know, f of n means dividing the problem and combining. The entire thing we call it as f of n. Okay, so now you come for this, consider the case a equals to b equals to t of 1 is equal to 2 and f of n. So just you substitute a, they have given the value 2, b, they have given value 2, at n by b. What is a? 2. 2t n by b, n is same, divided by what is b? 2 plus f of n is n. This is only just you are substituting the cases. So for this particular formula, you are substituting the values here. There is nothing more. So come for this. Look at the recurrence equation when n is power of 2. When n is power of 2, so what is the case? When n is 1, keep in your mind, it is not n minus 1, it is n equals 1. So power of 2. So anything to the power 1, you'll be taking it as 1 only. So minimum condition, by n equals 1, it will be t of 1. If n is greater than 1, so what is the case? It is n by 2 plus c. Okay, so this is the problems. So remaining thing, here I will be stopping. Remaining things we shall see in the next upcoming classes. So have you understood up to here? Have you got all concepts up to here? Okay, what is the recurrence equation for DNC? Kindly type in the chat box. What is the recurrence equation for DNC? What is the recurrence equation for DNC? Is first, what is the recurrence equation for D and C? Type in the chat box. Just you tell, if n is greater than 1, that means if the problem is small, big, so what is the recurrence equation? So see here, this is the recurrence equation for DNC. So if n is, okay, you have given, it is at n by b plus f of n, it is not c, AtN by B plus F of N. This is the recurrence equation for the divide and conquer method if the problem is big. Okay. So here I will be ending this particular class. Okay. Thank you all. Stay home, stay safe.